गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम पाटिल वीएस फ्रॉम एसजीएम कॉलेज कराड। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वन लेसन फ्रॉम अवर कोर्स बुक 1.3, द कॉल ऑफ द सॉइल, अ सेंट ऑफ राइस, रिटन बाय वेंकट अय्यर। बिफोर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द लेसन, फर्स्ट वी कैन सी सम शॉर्ट एक्टिविटीज अंडर आइस ब्रेकर्स। First, discuss the following with your partner and complete the following sentences. And there are 5 sentences. First, before eating apples brought from the market, I wash and peel them off to get rid of dirt and pesticides. Second, in a farmer's market we find, and we complete here is now. In a farmer's market we find locally grown fresh fruits and vegetables such as brinjals, green peas, etc. Third, food adulteration means, the addition of an inferior substance to a food atom in order to increase the quantity of the food atom. Food adulteration means the addition of an inferior substance to a food atom in order to increase the quantity of the food atom. Organic food is grown by using. Students, all of you know very well known about the organic food. Organic food is grown by using, and here we now complete the sentence. Organic food is grown by using natural fertilizers, natural pesticides, and traditional seeds. Organic fertilizer means, fertilizers of organic origin such as compost manure, green manure, and bone meal, etc. Now students, see second activity. There is one short wave now, and complete the following wave diagram. And main part of the wave here is rice varieties available at my grocer's shop. Rice varieties available at my grocer's shop is different types of rice such as kolam, then ambe mohar, basumati, jasmine, indrayani, etc. Means in the web there are 4 blank boxes here, and we have here now write the only the type of the rice. Its name of the varieties of names, basumati, kolam, jasmine, ambe mohar, means these varieties here, these rice varieties available at any grocer's shop. Next activity, you might have learned about organic farming. Means conventional farming and organic farming. Means today students, all of you know very well known about the difference between the conventional farming and organic farming. And our next activity here is now depend on these two types of farming. You might have learned about organic farming. Make groups and discuss the difference between the conventional farming and organic farming. And in our textbook here is a now short table. First year is now conventional farming, and next year is organic farming. Now here we can write the difference here between the conventional farming and organic farming. Conventional farming means in our mother tongue paramparik paddhatina keleli sheti, and next organic farming means sendriya sheti. Our title of the lesson here is the call of the soil, means mathichi saath, a scent of rice, tandracha sugandh. And our next activity here is a difference between the conventional farming and organic farming. Means in a conventional farming, we use chemical fertilizers, chemical pesticides and hybrids. But in organic farming, Sendriya Sheti, we use natural organic fertilizers. Organic fertilizers such as compost manure, green manure, bone meal, etc. Means in organic farming, we use natural or organic fertilizers. Again, in organic farming, we use natural pesticides or organic pesticides. And in organic farming, we use traditional seeds. In conventional farming, we used hybrid series, but in organic farming, we used traditional seeds. Now, students, look at the page number 26. First, I want to share some lines about the author Venkat Iyer. Venkat Iyer, born in 1966. Venkateshwaran Iyer is a science graduate and a certified project management professional. He last worked with IBM in Mumbai as a project manager for software implementation. After 17 years in the IT industry, he quit in 2004 to live on his organic farm in Pet Village in Dahanu Taluka, Palghar district, Maharashtra. Venkat Iyer, the author, who had quit his job in the IT industry to live on his farm. His book, Move Over Microchips, traces his transition from techie to farmer over a period of 15 to 17 years. It was not a career change but a lifestyle change I was looking for. The writer here is, he had quit his job in the IT industry and now he says that it was not a career change but a lifestyle change I was looking for. He says about the decision to shift to the quieter environs of a village. He insisted on practicing organic farming from the outset. The writer here is, he insisted here is on practicing organic farming. He was resolute in spite of numerous challenges which he faced. Today, not only does he deliver lectures on organic farming, but also has joined hand with organic farmers and NGOs working in the organic field to propagate organic farming, to ensure that the land at least is not here ravaged while they try to make a living out of agriculture. Means today, the writer Venkat Iyer, not only does he deliver lectures on organic farming, but also has joined with hands with organic farmers. Now, we start the lesson. In the lesson, there are two parts. First, the first crop, and second here is the scent of rice. Now, I begin. It was April 2004, I stood in the middle of the lush green field of moong, in bracket green gram, and looked around me. It was just before sunrise and the sky was turning a bright orange. The ground was damp and the leaves were shining with dew. My bare feet were muddy as I walked around gingerly inspecting the plants. Around me were rows of chikoo trees and below a dense foliage of moong. At that point, I could not have asked for anything more. The moong plants, not more than 2 feet tall, had green pods hanging out. The pods were not yet ripe, and there was a light furze growing on them. There was still some time before the harvest. I felt exhilarated. There are some new words now. First, now one new word here is now lush. Lush means growing luxuriantly, means thick, lush, jomana vadna. Again, one word gingerly. Gingerly means careful, foliage. Foliage means the leaves of a tree or a plant. Parna sambhar, foliage. Means beginning of the lesson, the writer here describes the scene on the farm, and the writer was happy. The writer was happy. There are some reasons for the author's happiness. Because first it was before sunrise, the sky was turning a bright orange, and the leaves shining with dew. The author was walking barefoot in his lush green field of moog, inspecting the plants. The writer was walking barefoot in his lush green field of moog and inspecting the plants. Around him, there were rows of chiku trees. And below, the leaves of moog plant with the green pods having a light fuzz on them, and there were again big trees around. The writer here is inspecting the plants. The writer now used some words or phrases that define the beauty of the nature, such as lush green, field of moog, sky turning bright orange, leaves were shining with dew, rows of chiku trees, etc. Means these some words writer here used that defines the beauty of the nature. The writer now inspecting here the plants, moog plants here is. There was still some time before the harvest, I felt exhilarated. The writer felt exhilarated. Exhilarated means very happy. The writer felt exhilarated because he was witnessing his first crop and couldn't believe that he owned such a beautiful land. The writer, as a farmer here is, the writer felt very happy, exhilarated, because now he was witnessing here is his first crop and couldn't believe that he owned such a beautiful land. Now he was looking at his first crop as a farmer. I stood watching the sunrise above the towering trees across the fence and slowly made my way back to the house. A white structure in the middle of this greenery. I could not believe that I was owner of this land. Means when the writer himself now inspecting his plants now here is, the writer could not believe that he was the owner of this land. I was looking at my first crop as a farmer. After I had paid the advance money for the land, I thought I would have some time to get familiar with farming. But Moru Dada, the broker who got us the land, had other ideas. He was keen that we plant moog at once. I was not prepared for this. I was still reading books and trying to figure out what we could sow and how we should go about it. Moru Dada was quite firm. He said the season was ripe for sowing moog and the best seeds were available in Surat in the adjacent state of Gujarat. The writer stood watching the sunrise above the towering trees across the fence and slowly made his way back to his house. But the writer could not believe that he was the owner of this land and he was looking at his first crop as a farmer. After the writer had paid the advance money for the land, the writer thought he would have some time to get familiar with farming. The writer himself now thought that he would have some time to get familiar with farming, but Morudada is one person from the village. The broker, anje madhyasth. Morudada, the broker who got us the land, had other ideas. Morudada has other ideas. He was keen that we plant mug at once. I was not prepared for this. The writer now was still reading some books and trying to figure out what he could sow and how he should go about it. The writer was first now reluctant to sow the mug because the writer wanted time to get familiar with farming. And he was still reading some books and trying to figure out what he could sow. But Morudada felt that the season was right for sowing mug. And so Morudada advised the writer the best seeds were available in Surat. Means actually here is the writer wanted time to get familiar with farming. And so the writer was reluctant to sow the mug, but Morudada advised him to sow the mug, and the best seeds were available in Surat in the adjacent state of Gujarat. I made a quick trip to Surat and bought around 10 kilograms of mug. Morudada rented his tractor to plow the land and quickly planted mug all over the place. A few days later, we were overjoyed to see tiny green leaves. I had never seen mug growing before and was thrilled at the sight. It was the same thrill I had felt as a young boy when I saw the first of the hibiscus. I had planted bloom at the railway quarters in Bile Parle in Mumbai. I was grateful to have taken Moru's advice. In the third paragraph, the writer now here used some words now related to agriculture, and there is one question now, find words now related to agriculture. Means there are many words now the writer now used here related to agriculture, such as field, mug, leaves, plants, chiku trees, green pods, ripe harvest, land, crop, farmer, farming, so etc. Means there are so many words now here related to agriculture. With the help of Morudada, the writer planted mug all over the land. All over his farm now. A few days later, both of them overjoyed. Means not only the writer as well as Morudada again. Both of them overjoyed to see tiny green leaves of mug. The writer was thrilled at the sight because he had never seen mug growing. He remembered when he was a young boy and he was living at the railway quarters in Bile Parle in Mumbai, and when he saw the first of the hibiscus, jaswanda's a pool. When the writer saw the first of the hibiscus he had planted bloom, and because of that he was thrilled and he felt the same thrilling at the same time. Means when the writer saw the tiny plants of the mug, The writer was thrilled at the sight because he had never seen moong growing. And so he, at that time, he remembered when he was a young boy and he was living at the railway quarters in Vile Parle in Mumbai, and when he saw the first of the hibiscus he had planted bloom, and because of that he was thrilled and he felt the same thrilling. म्हणजे ज्या वेळेला आता हे मुगाचं प्लांट बघितल्यावर जसे त्याच्यावरती त्याच्यावर द रायटर थ्रिल्ड, त्याच पद्धतीच्या भावना त्याच्या ज्या वेळेला त्यानं जास्वंदीचं फूल पहिल्यांदा उमलताना बघितलं होतं त्यावेळेला झालेल्या होत्या. द नेक्स्ट थिंग मोरूदादा वॉन्टेड टू डू वॉज स्प्रे सम पेस्टिसाइड ऑन द प्लांट्स. He claimed that it would give a higher yield. This was something we did not want to do. We were clear that we would not use any chemicals and tried to explain it to him. He reacted as if he had suggested harakiri. Harakiri, here is again one new word. It took a lot of convincing to ensure that Morudada and his friends did not use any chemicals on the farm. They refused to understand how crops could grow without sprays. Morudada advised the author to use some pesticides on the plant. Miss Morudada wanted here to use some pesticides on the plant, on the moong plant. Morudada claimed that it would give better yield, but the writer disagreed with him because the writer believed that the land was fertile and it was possible to grow crops without chemicals. Morudada believed that spraying pesticides would lead a higher yield. But the writer himself believed that the land was fertile and it was possible to grow crops without chemicals. In this para there is one new word, here is harakiri. He reacted as if we had suggested harakiri. Harakiri Harakiri, a formal way of killing yourself by cutting open your stomach with a sword. Harakiri here is Japanese way to killing oneself. आपल्याकडे म्हटलं जातं की स्वतःच्याच पायावर दगड मारून घेणं, म्हणजे स्वतःचं नुकसान स्वतः करून घेणं. हाराकिरी म्हणजे स्वतःचं नुकसान स्वतः करून घेणं. मोरूदादा here wanted to use some pesticides on the moong plant. But the writer now refused here, and so Morudada reacted as if we had suggested harakiri. It took a lot of convincing to ensure that Morudada and his friends did not use any chemicals on the farm. They refused to understand how crops could grow without sprays. Morudada and his some friends here is they refused to hear to understand now how crops could grow without sprays. But the writer here was now firm on his decision. Did not use, the writer decided the land was fertile and it was possible to grow crops without chemicals. Contrary to what everyone had told us, nature did her job and she needed no bribes to get the work done. Soon it was harvest time and we managed a respectable 300 kilograms. An awful lot of moong and with a lot of confidence. Now I was certain the land was fertile and it was possible to grow crops without chemicals. It was a major moral booster. The author, with the help of Morudada, he planted only 10 kilograms moong on his land. And then he got a good harvest in spite of using no chemicals. In spite of using no chemicals, no any pesticides. This showed that it was possible to get a good harvest if we left it on nature and allowed things to grow naturally without any artificial inputs. There is need to use additional unnatural things like chemicals. You see that, students? Actually, the writer had planted only 10 kilograms smoke in his land. And finally, he got 300 kilograms smoke with the help of organic farming. Means in his smoke plant, the writer only used here organic fertilizers, natural fertilizers. He didn't use any chemical pesticides now. He used his traditional seeds, and see the output here is. Means the writer now, he had quit his job now. And as a farmer, now see his first crop of the mook. Actually, the writer had planted only 10 kilograms mook in his land. And finally, he got 300 kilogram mooks. Okay, students. Now, in our today's lecture, we have studied the first part of the lesson. Thank you.